Suppose you're working on a project and need to process a large amount of data that happens to be publicly available on some website. You could scrape it manually, but that would be really inconvenient, so you decide to write a script that scrapes the data for you. Most websites aren't the biggest fans of you doing this, in part because scrapers don't pay any money or click ads, but use up a lot more bandwidth than regular users, which isn't free. As a result, they take countermeasures to block bots, and bot makers counter these measures with their own updates, leading to an interesting game of cat and mouse. The simplest way to block bot spam is to log the IP address of every request being made, and if the rate of requests goes over a certain threshold, the address gets blocked. This effectively reduces bot traffic, but a bot can spam a bit less or use a series of different IP addresses to continue operations. This motivates some slightly more sophisticated filters. When you open a web page in your browser and look at the request details in the console, you can notice a user agent section, which tells the server what browser and operating system you're using. The server can take this information and ensure it's provided invalid. Problematic header values can be safely attributed to bots, and the requests ignored. If you combine this with tracking a user's cookies across pages, changing them over time, and ensuring everything is coherent, you can more or less block any bot using simple web requests and not running a full-blown browser simulator. Making bots will then either require you to figure out the cookie pattern and conform, or use a more powerful tool along the lines of Playwright, Selenium, and Puppeteer. These let you create a virtual browser to navigate in, which deals with cookies, agents, and everything else for you, while also providing some pretty useful tools to help you parse the data. This may sound very nice, but a ghost browser comes alongside increased computation time and cost, which discourages scraping large quantities of data. At this point, the only people still scraping are casual users who just need a bit of data, or large companies who can afford the overhead. These companies are the second reason websites want to block scrapers, since competitors accessing your public data can provide them a significant business advantage over you. One creative way of stopping bots is to hide false information in the web page, but not visible to humans. Since bots look at the HTML of a page, they'll see this data, and if it's hidden in a subtle manner, any bot not designed around these honeypots will fall right into them. This is where we get to the heavy artillery. Captchas. The idea is to analyze how the bot interacts with the page itself to distinguish humans from bots. There are two main types of captchas, the pop-up boxes you're used to seeing, but also a subtle invisible one. The idea behind the latter is that humans are flawed. If you move your mouse from one point to another, the trajectory will be janky and irregular. But if a bot's code says to move the mouse from one point to another, it'll be a really straight line. And even, if you try to make it artificially chaotic, there'll be some regularity in it. In a similar way, typing has the same effect, since bots will tend to type with regular intervals between key presses. Making a bot as flawed as humans is tough, but detecting bot-like behavior is much easier. This is made even more accessible with AI, as it has tons of data on how humans act, and comparing patterns is a powerful way of detecting even some high-effort bots. Finally, we have pop-up captchas. The idea is to actively ask the user to solve a puzzle that is, in theory, easy for humans to do, but really hard for computers. You've probably seen these before, so let's just skip to how they're solved by bots. First of all, you have captcha farms, where you pay humans to solve captchas for you. Otherwise, artificial intelligence can be trained specifically on captchas and how to solve them, but this is expensive and technically difficult. Since I don't know how to do this, nor do I have the resources for it, if you want to scrape a website, I would recommend Byte Data, the sponsor of today's video. They've done the hard work of figuring out how to bypass captchas, setting up a proxy network, and making your bot's behavior more realistic. All of these tools can be accessed pretty effortlessly by just adding a few lines of code to your scraper, which sends it through the Byte Data portal, and it'll do all the work for you. If this interests you, check out the link in the description and try it out at no cost with their free plan. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.